I mean, yeah. I think the sort of fundamental good that Tesla can accomplish is acceleration of the inevitable, which is electric transportation. But I think there's a lot of value to accelerating to minimize the environmental and economic damage that would otherwise occur.
Mm-hmm. Here's the thing. For the last few years, we've been seeing the rise of EVs, which have often been hailed as the future of transportation that can save the environment and help the humanity in the longer run. But is that true? Or is it just an overhyped marketing gimmick like a well-planned scam that actually fixes nothing but instead creates more problems? I did some research into all of this, and what I came up with is kind of eye-opening. Let's get into it.
The future of transportation is the electric car!
Great. Electricity is our friend.
He celebrated like a pop star.
Everyone!
No, this truck is electrical!
First of all, EVs are not a new thing. As early as 1835, Professor Sybrandus Stratton built a small-scale electric car, and by the 1900s, nearly 28% of all cars on American roads were electric. Even President Woodrow Wilson was seen touring in an EV. So why didn't they just take off back then? The answer is quite simple. It's batteries. Early batteries were slow to charge and offered limited range, leading to what we now call as range anxiety. So, people couldn't consider driving long distances with these vehicles. And with such limitations, EVs simply couldn't compete with gasoline-powered cars. Fast forward to today, and EVs are all the rage. Mainly because of environmental concerns, but also Elon Musk and Tesla. They make EVs look really cool. Battery technology has also advanced enough that we can drive a good amount of distance with a single charge. And if that wasn't enough, EVs have some of the most amazing performance perks. Let's talk about speed. Unlike traditional cars, EVs excel when it comes to quick acceleration, meaning achieving a higher speed in a lesser amount of time.
Further, EVs also don't have the clutch and gear transmission system, which means the driving experience is far superior.
And due to this, there are less moving parts in the car, which means less chances of things breaking down, ultimately resulting in less car maintenance. And when it comes to fuel efficiency, EVs are really efficient because they utilize about 70 to 80% of the energy that goes inside of it versus gasoline cars, which utilize about 20%, making them quite inefficient. And due to all this, the running cost of an EV is way lower than that of a traditional car. But it's not all sunshine and rainbows, and EVs do have their own set of issues. And that's quite a long list too, so let's get started on that. The energy that powers these EVs in most countries is still generated by burning coal, which means the carbon footprint isn't as green as you might think. Then there are the batteries which these EVs run on. That consists mostly of lithium, a toxic element that utilizes a lot of fresh water for its mining process and ultimately also leads to land degradation. And let's not forget what we're trying to replace here. It's fossil fuels like petrol and gasoline. That's because these are naturally occurring substances that are limited in quantity. And somehow we have replaced it with lithium, which once again is a naturally occurring substance limited in quantity. And if that's not it, there are several reports which state that there are underage children working in these mines in Africa. And those were just the environmental and ethical concerns. But let's also not forget the cost concern, which actually makes EVs far more expensive than their gas or petrol counterparts.
Like in the US, there can be a significant cost difference between gas cars versus EVs, even the cheapest ones. In countries like India, EVs can cost up to twice as much, so it barely makes any sense for a regular person to buy an EV as they won't be able to justify the cost.
And beyond this, range anxiety is still there. And unlike a 10-minute visit to the gas station to get your tank full, recharging an EV is not that quick. Especially if you're getting it recharged at your home, it can practically take several hours for that. Plus, the high cost of battery replacement after the end of its life is a significant cost, especially in budget cars, and this becomes a deal breaker for most people. And I know, this doesn't sound good at all. But we do have solutions. And obviously, it starts with batteries.
Replacing lithium with alternatives like graphene, sodium ion, or solid-state batteries could be huge.
Because these materials are easily available and doesn't involve a dangerous mining process. But similarly, as long as we have to use lithium, we need to ensure that there are regulations in place for its proper recycling. Believe me, it's not just about the batteries. Generating electricity using renewable resources such as wind and solar is also essential.
Imagine if every home could harness the power of the sun to charge their car. That would lead to a zero carbon footprint.
And when it comes to EV charging, we need to approach it with a completely different behavior.
I mean, imagine your office parking lot, or mall, or a residential area. All these can be used as a charging station.
And the best part is the technology already exists.
Streetlights could easily become EV charging spots,
which means you don't really need to build anything substantial.
So you see, EVs can be considered genius or an overhyped trend depending on how all these additional parameters play out in the longer run.
Clearly, there's a lot of work to be done. But if we can solve these challenges, I'm quite sure EVs can be a major step towards a cleaner and more sustainable environment.